各位好，咁就今日咧就法庭喺11点咧就颁下判词咧，就就住之前咧有几位人士咧就住一地两检是否合法合宪咧就作咗一个司法复核嘅。咁喺大家都可能手上都或者可能都有睇过个判词啦。咁咧我喺呢度咧作一個簡單嘅回應啦，作為一地兩檢關注組嘅成員，亦都係公民黨嘅立法會議員，一直跟咗呢個一地兩檢咁耐。大家如果記得嘅話咧，一地兩檢嘅正式宣布咧係由舊年嘅七月尾開始，應該係如果冇記錯份文件，應該係7月25日到而家。咁當然啦，高鐵亦都喺早前已經開通咗。咁高鐵本身有啲咩問題咧？或者運作上邊啊，財務安排上邊，我諗大家好多傳媒都有關注噶啦。咁但係就住今次嘅一個一地兩檢嘅安排是否合法合憲咧？咁法庭作出一個裁決。咁我自己本人咧當然係對呢一個裁決係表示失望嘅，因為咧法庭係認為佢合憲。咁但係當然啦，咁我哋亦都要睇翻本身佢嘅理由啦。最重要嘅，而今次咧，我想講咧一個嘅裁決咧，其實我諗最大嘅影響咧，其實當然我哋係預計咗，亦都預計得到咧，法庭係會有一個可能係咁樣嘅判決嘅，但係我仍然係表示失望啦。而且咧，亦都可以話咧，今次其實到最後呢班申請人，無論輸同埋贏咧，到最後我認為輸嘅咧，都係基本法對香港人嘅法律上面嘅保障。咁點解我特登攞翻呢本基本法出嚟咧？因為而家大家唔會再攞到呢一本基本法噶啦。因為而家就算連立法會議員喺議事廳裏面嗰本基本法，我哋有嘅呢一本基本法上面已經有一個中國憲法喺上面騎住我哋基本法。點解我要特登攞翻一個舊版出嚟？基本法係香港嘅基礎。但不過好可惜，呢個其實判決無論贏輸，到最後都係我哋都係即係基本法對我哋保障都係會有影響。點解我會咁講呢？如果今時而家你見到輸咗啦，即係申請人。但就算申請人贏咗，政府都好可能會係去釋法，係去尋求人大常委嘅再次即係就住香港嘅事務去釋法。咁呢一樣嘢亦都係對香港一個法治上面最大嘅破壞。所以其實無論贏輸咧，其實對我哋香港嚟講咧，這個基本法嘅保障都係輸咗。咁當然咧大家睇翻個判詞內容啦。其實最主要咧，我哋見得到咧，法官咧係就住呢一個一地兩檢咧，最重要係有一個邏輯嘅。咁咧就係話咧，因為呢個基本法裏面咧係冇話到一地兩檢係違法嘅，係冇唔準基本法係冇喺基本法裏面冇排除到或者冇話過一地兩檢咧係唔可以做嘅，係 prohibited 啊，即係英文係 prohibited。咁所以咧就可以做啦。咁而根據呢一個邏輯嘅話咧，其實我好擔心咧，有好多嘢都可以喺香港做，因為咧一本基本法咧係冇可能囊括曬所有香港即係喺基本法定立之後所發生嘅每一個狀況。而我哋最重要就係睇翻基本法本身裡面嘅一啲好重要嘅一啲基礎或者一啲原則。咁但係好可惜咧，今次咧就似乎我哋見到咧，即係如果以咁樣嘅邏輯嘅話咧，其實咧基本法可以幫香港人守住我哋嘅自由人權嘅話咧，我都擔心咧可能係會受到影響啦。咁當然啦，喺判詞上面咧法官係試圖咧就去解釋翻咧唔會咧係令到一地兩檢係會喺香港咧更多地方發生嘅，因為咧這個咧係要睇翻個別嘅個案而定。咁但係咧我哋即管可以話係拭目以待。因為今次咧，其實法官喺判詞嗰度亦都有交代到咧，可以令到過程更快、更方便咧，都係一個佢考慮之列嘅，都係一個考慮嘅因素嚟嘅。咁呢一樣嘢，我相信如果係可以令到大家過關更快捷嘅，都會係一個考慮嘅理由嘅話咧，咁我相信有好多關口咧，都可能有機會會實施更快捷嘅安排噶啦。咁當然另外咧，要講翻一個非常之重要嘅問題，如果大家仲記得一地兩檢呢？ 其實有一步係三步走嘅時候咧，有一步係非常之重要嘅，就係關於呢一個人大常委嘅決定。嗱，大家如果睇翻基本法第158條咧，我哋一直都係講緊人大釋法，而即係話本身有一條法律，而之後再揾人大釋法。但係今次咧係調翻轉頭，成個一地兩檢嘅安排咧係未有一地兩檢嘅草案之前。就已經揾咗人大常委釋定法，我嗰陣時講過好多次噶啦，嚇唔係啲咩釋定法，係而係真係一早就已經喺2017年12月27日已經釋定法，為咗一地兩檢釋咗法啦。咁而今次喺判詞嗰度亦都引用，而且仲確認咗一樣嘢，就係事前嘅釋定法。同事後根據基本法，無論你跟足基本法每一步驟，或者超越曬基本法要去做嘅步驟，即係跟158去釋法，呢兩樣嘢，人大常委嘅決定同釋法嗰個差唔多已經有等同嘅地位，而大家都要再留意翻本身個決定嘅內容，即係人大常委喺12月27日嗰陣時嘅決定咧，佢唔單止係解釋一地兩檢，佢仲有係話香港嘅立法會。是要就住一地兩檢去制定法律，咁大家就可以想像得到，一我哋已經睇得到咧，其實這個人大釋法或者而家仲包埋釋定法，對香港嘅司法制度可以話係緊箍咒，因為這個判詞都有講到啦。如果大家唔滿意，其實佢因為係一個終審法院嘅判決，佢要跟，咁而佢就再伸延到令到事前嘅人大決定都有等同嘅地位嘅話，如果你覺得唔係嘅話，你就翻到去終審法院啦。咁好明顯，而家已經成為咗一個緊箍咒啦。而第二係最我覺得係一個魔爪伸咗出嚟嘅咧，就係呢一個嘅人大嘅決定咧，不單止係影響咗我哋嘅法院，而且影響埋我哋嘅立法會，即係而家可以咧係用人大常委嘅決定去指揮。去命令立法會去就住佢嘅一啲決定去定立法律，呢一樣嘢不單止影響我哋嘅司法，更加影響咗我哋嘅立法。咁即係話咧，你立咗條法，事後佢可幫你釋法；你未立法，我事前就幫你釋定法，你跟住做啦。咁呢一樣嘢咧，我覺得咧，可以話係對立法同埋對司法，即係香港兩個非常之重要嘅基石咧，係影響深遠嘅。咁所以咧，公民黨或者作為一地兩檢關注組嘅召集人咧，我要再一次講，其實今次成個嘅判詞，我諗最令到我失望嘅地方係，因為無論輸贏，即係我講緊個判，即係個呢個嘅新，即係呢一個司法覆核嘅個案，無論輸贏到最後咧，我哋香港人都係輸，而最重要嘅就係因為基本法。對我哋保障好可能就已經會越嚟越退色，咁而但係我亦都希望咧，無論係香港人同埋國際社會要繼續關注香港每一項嘅措施，特別係就住一地兩檢是特別係就住一國兩制是否能夠成功喺香港落實，這個咧希望大家會繼續關注嘅，唔該。
You can, of course, I don't know whether the Standing Committee will make controversial decision regarding Hong Kong's issues or policies. But obviously, you can see that based on this judgment, you can see that the decision of MPCSC, the Standing Committee decision, has an equivalent position as the interpretation under Article 158 of Basic Law. So that's. I would say this is an extension of the power of MPCSC, and this will definitely affect not only the judiciary, because you can see that due to a CFA judgment, the interpretation of MPCSC regarding basic law would have a bearing in Hong Kong's policy. But at the same time, this time we can see that even before such a law has been made, the Standing Committee can exercise their power and make such a decision to have a bearing or even to command Hong Kong legislature to follow that decision and to make the law accordingly. So that is the decision, or this is a command to not only the legislature. In fact, of course, this is again the administration will follow the decision of the standing committee. So you can see that the separation of powers, or even the powers of the legislature and the administration, is severely affected by this decision. Definitely this would have a very, very long-term effect or consequences on the whole development of Hong Kong. So I urged everyone, in particular Hong Kong people and the international world, to pay attention to the application of the one country, two system and our basic law. And basic law, of course, I'm quite disappointed with this the effect of this judgment, in a sense that this will definitely undermine the protection of basic law. That's the situation, unfortunately. Thank you.